went over the room. I want you to protect yourself at all times, and what I say, you must obey. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you. They could have picked any venue in the world, but they chose this one for a reason. What an atmosphere. This is the Lighthouse Theater. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
You tried to give me the slip, didn't you, my friend? There was no way I was going to miss this.
Time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. And across the ring from him, Tyson Fury. He stands an imposing 6. And yes, he is the greatest, Muhammad Ali. Fighting out of Louisville, Kentucky. Smoke like a... The Gypsy King, Tyson Fury. This multi-time heavyweight champion of the world. Has been done. It's time to start doing the walking.
Todd, I'm going to stay here till the end of the night until the last.
And we're off and running between these two really accomplished fighters. Let's see how they come out. He just misses with that jab. Punch. Good left counter that lands. Both men step back for just a moment. Oh, it's Tyson Fury. Just that right. This could be it. Tyson Fury, one of the great heavyweight champions. He's trying to fight his way back into this. I don't know what his game plan is. This round, the momentum continues to shift. Which one of these athletes is going to say I can't take it anymore?
Oh, this is what it's all about. Don't get hit. Jab, move, pop, slip. Use your footwork. Drive your opponent crazy.
Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
He knows he's been hurt. He's gonna come out and put the pressure on. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at him. You gotta be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him up. Be smart, because he's gonna try and put you on the pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Just misses with that big right hand. Nice exchange here from both men. Through the hook, did the spin. Thank you.
to recover now. They've got to block it. They've got to block it. They've got to come up now and style it out. Get on the back foot. Jab. Rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then, put the pressure on.
This fight is all about distance for this man, and you can see he's using that length advantage.
Very smart, very sharp. This is a young man's style that he's got to get inside that lane. No one tries to do that.
Say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him, tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
We know what the game plan is going to be for this fighter. He's got to stick and move and avoid the big shots from the bigger man.
You're in there with a guy so big in front of you. You've got to be smart. You've got to use your smart. Use that skill. This is what you have to prepare for. Right past you and push his own way on him.
What you're seeing as you reach the halfway point of this round. Since back for just a moment. Just when you thought we'd see a lull in the action, here we go again. But we don't care. We want the heavy fist.
These are big units there, so I'm expecting power. We're going to have excitement. We're going to have drama because when these guys slow down.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. That last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on you. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until you're sent to the comeback.
Oh, with that left hook. I hear people talking about a boxer's chin. Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight.
I've seen some fights with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer. They are not going to move. Then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like this. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this is the dangerous part.
I think a judge in this fight is both up to the top on it. Vince, come back for just a moment. Round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab. It can be intimidating. It just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Fighters are just gifted. Gifted with just hand speed, footwork, movement. They are gifted. They are the chosen few.
Got out of the way that right hook. Missed him with that uppercut. 10 seconds to go. Thank you.
that could be the real difference. Power, that power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
This guy realizes that defense is the same area in boxing. Gets out of the way of that left hand. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go.
One-way traffic. How do they turn this around? Carries away that left hook. Precision shot, and they're coming at lightning speed.
I've never seen a final in my life. How do you think? You've got to hope they run out of steam.
And just missed with that left jab. Fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they're the one pushing the tempo?
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, the knockout punch. They want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
Cards lead. There are no losers in this one. A round that seemed like eternity for them finally comes to a close.
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
Here's the bell start round nine. That corner has got to find a way to get some momentum behind their fighter. Punch. Strategy. Those punches are doing nothing. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that tempo heavily, how do you deal with it?
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, thinking, you've just got to be smarter than them. You've got to be like a little faggot and pickpocket them.
Those who thought this would be a mismatch, you were totally wrong. That hook is off target. We'll be right back.
finish in this one.
Round 11. So not the best round, but let's see if they can turn it around here. Both men set back for just a moment. One of these fighters is starting to run out of gas. What do you do as a fighter when you just don't have the energy?
You've got the fighters that are absolutely shattered. What does this do? Willpower. Calm, because if you panic, you get desperate. You get desperate, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
Thank you.
fancy now.
Down to the 12. Let's see how much recovery they saw there in the last minute.
An amazing pace and tempo set in the last round. Can you keep this up? Me personally, I don't think that's possible. And if they can, their training, their conditioning would have been ridiculous, like they're in the army. But these guys, if they can keep up this pace, we are in for a great night.
Fighters are starting to run out of gas. What do you do as a fighter when you just don't have the energy?
Midway through the fight, if you are tired, this can be the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated, now we're gonna find out.
This has been a very competitive round between these two. He parries that right jab away. Jab away. Very competitive round with 10 seconds left.
Feeling like I got a brand new contract. I'm the dangerous, I'm ready for combat. Soon as I catch him on sight, it's contact. I get the job done proper, there's no comebacks. That's not fair, people hoping on the balance. But either you got that magic or you haven't. And we were born and blessed with all this talent. Soon as we give it a task, so apparent, I'm fully prepared, fully activated and ready. Focused on the target, grab my weapon, hold it steady, your name. You know that aim rain's heavy. Got the beast in me screaming out, let me out the cage. I ain't gotta do it with rage. The days are numbered, see my steps are calculated. On time, not a second hour late. Witnessing the mastery that we display like a hitman. Yeah. See, I go in and get the job done. Like I've been doing this for centuries. Before the events I would practice while it was empty. Never needed approval, all I needed was improvement. Got swift with the movement, I attack and defend. We ain't.
I'm Todd Grisham, and not a bad day for a fight. We're live at the Empire Fight Camp. Next to me is Johnny Nelson.
Looking forward to this one, Todd.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Smoking Joe Frazier. He took part in the greatest boxing trilogy of all time with Muhammad Ali. He defines the words Philly fighter. And across the ring from him, Muhammad Ali, 6'3" tall, the best to ever do it.
An amazing reach advantage.
Smoking Joe Frazier, his three battles with Muhammad Ali, perhaps the most famous the sport has ever. He is the great. Usually you don't need a weather report for him.
Thank you.
get it started in round three. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough first round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
Fight is all about distance for this man, and you can see he's using that length advantage.
Very smart, very sharp. This is a good young man style that he's got to get inside that long reach. Not many fights can do that.
Nice job by him to block that jab.
Because they can push, because they've got the weight behind them. They may not be connected, but trust me, when they connect, that's when this fight sets on fire. Because someone's going to get hurt, and someone's going to win.
He's going to keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots. But come on, that leaves more opportunities for headshots. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
I seriously hope.
There's the bell to start round four. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Both men step back for just a moment. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. This fighter has tested their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power shots.
Oh, you know what? Sometimes on a dirty ring with fighters like that, when you punch them, you just want to run. You want that spaceship to come and lift you out there because you think, what the hell am I going to do now?
We're at the halfway point of this round, and both of these fighters have had their moments. Still could go either way. And this is a you hit me hard, I'll hit you hard type of fight. Which one of these athletes is going to say I can't take it anymore? With 10 seconds left. He is down big time in the score. Every second. Things are starting to heat up now as we enter the fifth. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
He knows he's been hurt. He's going to come up with the pressure on. He's going to throw the kick and sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart because he's going to try and put you on the feet. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Great equalizers in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that
punch, when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster, you've just got to use brain.
The big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type have we seen so far?
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown the shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. And you've got to be careful.
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy?
Raise the bell with that last kick. There's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. No way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Work the body, frustrate them, take the mind off the chin, take the mind off protecting everything around them. Work the body, use tactics sometimes. Watch out, block the fight, and beat them on points.
This has been a very competitive round between these two. Neither fighter willing to sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. Neither man really defending themselves. You'd like to see more jabs. Here from both men. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Well, he is glad to have heard that bell.
Needs a knockout without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know.
Round seven, here we go. Not the start that they wanted, but let's see what they can do in this round.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure on.
You've got someone with the hand speed that each fighter possesses. How do you deal with it?
Gotta ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable, drag them, get them complaining to the referee, because once somebody with extra foot speed and extra power gets into the rhythm, the fight is over.
Blocks the right hook. Closer than I think a lot of people thought. These power punches are bruising up his body. One of
used to have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. It's how well you can take a punch to the face.
The problem with having a chin that everyone knows if they hit you, you'll hurt your arm. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And they forget, you can bang too.
Threw the hook, didn't land.
Despite what the judges forecast agreed, there are no losers in this one.
Talk about a one-sided 3 minutes, we just saw it.
You can't lose it.
And we enter the eighth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. So far, it seems like aggression has been the key. This fighter just not slowing down.
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be, having second thoughts in the ring.
Going to keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots. But that leaves more opportunities for headshots. Pretty close fight here in this round. You'd like to see this fighter protect themselves a little bit. His training camp. This round still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. At this point, you gotta believe he can't win on the scorecards, gonna need a knockout.
You're absolutely
the belt for round nine. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations you've just been handed for the nightmare again. Be smart, be sharp. Don't be afraid, and don't get sick for this. Make you fight your fight. Hold and tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's gonna pop you off.
Best attributes to have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. It's how well you can take a punch to the face.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for those top rails over the eyebrows, the cheekbone. You've just got to try and cut them, skim them, go for speed.
By the way. after he can see the fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of punches, and they're not throwing as many on their own.
You've got two fighters that can't from Martin Shaffer. What can you create with no power? Calm, because if you panic, you get desperate. If you get desperate, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
Can go punch to punch. Their resistance to these blows is 100%.
This is what he's getting in and feeling like your chin punch, because you know you brother chin is not going to get done.
Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. To lose another round.
But well, sometimes it can be the
This is the 11th. We've entered the championship round. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here. Timing beats speed.
Having so much speed, what happens to your opponent is you get caught to rhythm, and that's where the referee has to jump in and stop time. And we know this is going to happen, so you rush your work. You think, I've got to get him inside coach out.
You play through the round, and man, these two are going.
When you think you come up, Baron, move away. You walk back to the corner like you've just seen the sun.
There's the bell to start round 12. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here. That's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
When getting in there with somebody that's so fast, you're prepared to take a lick at it. Because you've got to get some before you get in close.
jab.
What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything. And when you let those shots go, and it just bats enough and they're walking down. It's so demoralizing. That's the extra great job. What else can you do?
Look at these men showing exceptional chins, by the way.
It is a draw. No winners and no losers here.
What a fight. What a battle. I'm exhausted watching it myself. And you know what? I'm happy it's a draw because nobody deserved to lose and nobody deserved to win. These guys put it on the line.
Will you live? Will you die? Will you quit? Will you try? Sweating eyes, who am I? Who am I? Champion till I die.
It's a full moon, so look out. We are live outside at Empire Fight Camp. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
The pleasure's always mine, my friend.
Time for our tale of the tape. Deontay Wilder, 6'7" tall with that massive 83-inch reach. And he'll be taking on Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach.
There is no joke about this. Someone...
Here he comes, the bronze bomber, Deontay Wilder, only 216. You've heard of people dancing underneath the moonlight tonight? It's a fight underneath the moonlight, and what a fight it should be.
The clouds have held the rain back. It's getting breezy.
Many said this fight would never happen, and yet here it is, and here we go. Through the hook, did land. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Counter right hand again. He blocks the hook. Worked out pretty well for him so far.
Sluggers just want to mow you down. They want to walk straight through as though you do not exist.
You've got to be fit for this one.
This fight a little bit closer than I think a lot of people thought. And with the right counter.
Someone's gonna get hurt.
the moment.
Time winding down as we get set for another round. Here we go, round four. Who's going to land the first big shot? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet, not until you're safe for the comeback.
United's concerned with how many points.
Nice job by him to block that jab.
trainer needs to come in and say something special. This here comes round seven. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's being hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him up. Be smart because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your legs are not tired. Three shots.
We'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power. And I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that
works. What should I take? Because all of a sudden, you're going to test yourself by trying to block that shot. And that's when he caught you.
Now, and that is not the way anyone wanted this fight to end.
No complaints there at all. The crowd agree, I agree. The ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.
As expected, not a ticket left, ladies and gentlemen. We are sold out at the Grand Theater. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
It's action night.
It's time for our tale of the tape. The gentleman of boxing, Floyd Patterson, 6 foot tall, 172 pounds, with a 71-inch reach. And he'll be taking on, yes indeed, Muhammad Ali, 6 foot three. The gentleman of boxing, Floyd Patterson. He started his career as an Olympic gold medalist, and look at him now. He is the former heavyweight champion of the world. The greatest, Muhammad Ali.
Thank you.
just been hurt, you've got to get out there again. Be smart, be sharp. Don't be a fool, don't get sucked into this. Make him fight, fight. Hold and tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to cut you off.
Because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to who's in better shape.
And you've got two fighters that are absolutely shattered. What gets your pace? Look at the power. Calm, because if you panic and get desperate, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked.
This has been a very competitive round as we reach the midway point.
And just misses with that jab.
Make it so easy.
said. I've seen some guys with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to be. Then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like a chip. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. This is the danger.
Shout. I look forward to fight number two.